year children. Today our teaching topic is coordinate geometry part 1. In this topic we discuss coordinate plane, plotting ordered pairs on a graph sheet and distance between two points. The coordinate plane is organized around two axes, the x-axis running horizontally and the y-axis running vertically. The position of a point on the plane is described by two numbers that measure the distance from the point to these two reference lines. My dear children, observe carefully on the screen. This is x-axis and this is y-axis. On x-axis, towards right side, all positive values. Left side, all negative values. Similarly, on y-axis, upwards, all positive values are written and downwards, all negative values are written. This plane is quadrant 1. All positive and positive points will be plotted on this plane. And here this plane is Q2, quadrant 2, minus plus. Ordered pairs will be plotted on this quadrant. This is Q3, quadrant 3, all negative and negative. First coordinate and second coordinate, both negative points will be plotted on this quadrant. This is Q4, plus minus. First coordinate plus, second coordinate minus. Ordered pairs will be plotted in this quadrant 4. Ordered pairs x comma y. In the ordered pair x comma y, x is said to be x coordinate, y is said to be y coordinate. The other names are also written there. X coordinate also will be called as abscissa, y coordinate also will be called as ordinate, and first coordinate is x coordinate and second coordinate is y coordinate. Let us plot these points on the graph sheet. First 2, 5, 2 units on x and 5 units on y we should know. Here this is the point 2, 5. Next point 4, 4. 4 and 4. 4, 4. 8, 0. We have to move 8 on x-axis and no on y-axis. This is 8, 0. Next one. -3, -5. This is -3 and -5. Next 0, 8. 0, 8. Now let us discuss about the derivation of distance between two points if two coordinates are given. That is, the distance between two points is square root of x2 minus x square plus y2 minus y1 square. First, construct the vertical and horizontal line segments passing through each of the given points such that they meet at the 90 degrees angle. A, x1, y1, B, x2, y2. Now, join AB. We have to find the distance between AB. And now a perpendicular is drawn from B to x-axis. It meets at N. Now also draw another perpendicular from point A to x-axis. It intersects x-axis at M. Now, origin to M is x1. And M to A is y1. O to N is x2 and N to B is y2. Now, MN is the difference between the two points x2 minus x1. In A MNC rectangle, MN is equals to AC. Since it is a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. Now, CB is equals to BN minus CN, that is Y2 minus Y1. Now, in triangle ABC, right angle is at C. Then AC is equals to adjacent side and BC is equals to opposite side. Adjacent is equals to X2 minus X1. Opposite is equals to Y2 minus Y1. And we have to find the hypotenuse AB that is equals to how? And we have to use Pythagoras theorem. Applying Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equals to opposite square plus adjacent square. AB square is equals to BC square plus AC square is equals to X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Therefore, AB is equals to square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Distance between two points, if two coordinates are given, then it is equals to AB equals to square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. Now, let us observe some problems based on the distance formulae. Find a relation between X and Y such that the point X, Y is equidistant from point X 7, 1 and 3, 5. My dear children, observe on the screen. Let P, X, Y be equidistant from the point A, 7, 1 and B, 3, 5. Then, AP is equals to BP. AP square is also equals to BP square using distance formula. Then, AP square is equals to X minus 7 whole square plus Y minus 1 whole square is equals to X minus 3 whole square plus Y minus 5 whole square. That is expanding by using a minus b whole square, x square minus 14x plus 49 plus y square minus 2y plus 1 equals to x square minus 6y plus 9 plus y square minus 10y plus 25. Now, x square will be gets cancelled. Similarly, y square will be gets cancelled on both equations, both sides. Now, remaining terms are minus 14x plus 49 minus 2y plus 1 is equals to minus 6x plus 9 minus 10y plus 25. Now, rearranging the terms or transposing the terms, we have minus 14x plus 6x plus 49 plus 1 minus 9 minus 25 minus 2y plus 10y is equals to 0. After simplification, it is 8 into x minus y is equals to 16. Transpose 8 to RHS, it becomes x minus y is equals to 2. Hence, the relation between x and y is x minus y is equals to 2. Name the type of triangle formed by the points A minus 5 comma 6, B minus 4 comma minus 2 and C 7 comma 5. Given points A minus 5 comma 6, B minus 4 comma minus 2. Let us find the distance between A, B. Using distance formula, D is equals to square root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. And AB is equals to square root of minus 4 plus 5 whole square plus minus 2 minus 6 whole square. That is equals to 1 plus 64 square root of and square root of 65. And similarly, B minus 4 minus 2 and C 7 comma 5. Then BC is equals to square root of 7 minus of minus 4 plus 4 whole square plus 5 plus 2 whole square. That is equals to 121 plus 49. That is equals to root 170. Similarly, AC minus 5 comma 6, 7 comma 5. AC is equal to square root of 7 plus 5 whole square plus 5 minus 2 whole square. That is equals to 144 plus 1. That is equals to square root 145. Hence, all the sides are equal. Since all sides are different lengths, therefore ABC is a scalene triangle. value of the k if the point P 2, 4 is equidistant from the point A 5, k and B k, 7. Observe the picture on the screen, my dear children. Let P 2, 4 A 5, k and B k, 7. P A is equals to P B given. P A square is equals to P B square, squaring on both sides. And then 5 minus 2 whole square plus k minus 4 whole square is equals to k minus 2 whole square plus 7 minus 4 whole square. That is equals to 9 plus k minus 4 whole square minus k minus 2 whole square is equals to 9. On both sides, 9 will be gets cancelled. The remaining terms, by using a square minus b square algebraic identity, a plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square is equals to a plus b into a minus b. That is equals to k minus 4 plus k minus 2 into k minus 4 minus k plus 2 equals to 0. Since a square minus b square is equals to a plus b into a minus b. Therefore, 2k minus 6 into minus 2 equals to 0. And 2k minus 6 is equals to 0 and 2k is equals to 6 implies k is equals to 3. Show that points A 4, 5 and B 7, 6, C 4, 3 and D 1, 2 form a parallelogram. My dear children, observe the rough diagram of a parallelogram. Then what we have to prove? To show it is a parallelogram, we have to prove opposite sides are equal and the diagonals are unequal. Then it holds good. Given points are A 4, 5, B 7, 6, C 4, 3, D 1, 2. Now x1, y1, x2, y2, and it is the distance formula, square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now let us find the distance between AB. A 4, 5, B 7, 6, that is equals to AB is equal to square root of 7 minus 4 x2 minus x1 whole square, 7 minus 4 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, 6 to y6 minus 5 whole square is equals to square root of 9 plus 1, that is square root of 10. Similarly, find the distance between B and C. BC is equals to square root of 4 minus 7 whole square plus 3 minus 6 whole square is equals to square root of 9 plus 9 is 18, root 18. Next, CD, distance between C and D, 4, 3, and D, 1, 2. CD is equal to square root of 1 minus 4 whole square plus 2 minus 3 whole square. That is equals to square root of 9 plus 1 is equals to square root 10. Similarly, DA, D, 1, 2, A, 4, 5. DA is equal to square root of 1 minus 4 whole square plus 2 minus 5 whole square. That is equals to square root of 9 plus 9. That is square root 18. And AC, that length of the diagonal. AC is equal to square root of C, square root of 4 minus 4 whole square plus 3 minus 5 whole square. That is equals to square root of 0 plus 4 is equals to square root of 4 equals to 2. BD is equal to square root of 1 minus 7 whole square plus 6 minus 2 whole square. That is equals to square root of 36 plus 16 equals to square root over 52. That is 2 root 13. Opposite sides of the quadrilateral formed by the given four points are equal and the diagonals are unequal. Therefore, the given points form a parallelogram. My dear children, some problems were given on the screen. Observe carefully. If you can, you do yourself. And if you did not get, you ask your class teacher for help. Thank you, my dear children.